is that time for the stunning upsets in the Cinderella teams. Remember back in 2005, Vermont upsetting Syracuse in a big dance? What will the Catamounts be able to do this year? Back in the dance for the first time since that year. The coach of the America East Champs, Mike Lonergan, joins us now to talk about it. And coach, it's been almost 24 hours since you won it all. So what's it been like for you and your team?
It's been pretty hectic. It's been great. A lot of text messages and emails and congratulatory calls. Our guys are real excited, and I know the whole state is happy that Vermont's back in the big dance.
Who are some of those messages and text messages? Who are some of the people you got those text messages from?
Well, Senator Leahy called me last night from Vermont, and Gary Williams, I had emailed him congratulating on Coach of the Year. I work for Coach Williams, and he sent me a nice message today, and just a lot of my friends and family, and, it's just been real exciting, and everybody's really happy for us.
Yeah, exciting. But, as you wait right now, you're going to find out in a couple of hours here or an hour or so, how would you describe your emotions?
Well, now it's kind of like I knew we won a championship yesterday, but my whole life, I've kind of wanted to get in a big dance. I made 9 NCAA tournaments in my 12 years as Division III coach, but, it's just a lot more exciting now, and just to be able to watch that show for the first time. It was our third championship game, but the first time we won it, so now it's kind of crazy knowing that our name, Vermont, is going to come across the screen.
Where are you and your team going to watch the tournament selection show from?
The Upper Deck Sports Pub in South Burlington, where I do my radio show.
Yeah, once again, so if you get a bad selection, at least you have some drinks to calm your nerves a little bit once you find out who you're playing against.
I think I had a couple last night. I'm good for a while.
Have you thought about a seed, a region, or best-case scenario for this team?
I didn't look at any of that ahead of time, but I think that we're deserving of a 14 or at least a 15 seed. We played pretty tough schedule. I think we have the most road wins in the entire country. We have 25 wins, but we're kind of thinking there might be some interesting matchups. My assistant coach Matt Hahn, his dad Billy Hahn, is assistant at West Virginia, so I think Matt kind of wants to play, give a chance for his mom to see him and his dad the same site. So I really don't care who we play though.
Speaking of moms and dads, of course you got a player Evan Fields who lost his mom to cancer just a week ago. What's been the emotions of the team, and have you guys sort of rallied around that devastating loss?
Yeah, I think it really brought our team, which was a close team, closer together. Evan kept it from his teammates and our coaching staff that his mom even had cancer, and he just did not want it to be a distraction. I think he just played his season for her, and she passed away Tuesday. But he didn't have his best game, but it was just so emotional for him, and I'm so glad we were able to win. So he got a little bit of joy yesterday afternoon and last night. He's got a terrific family, and I tell you, he's a strong young man, the way he handled the whole situation.
All right, one last question. You got this kid, Marcus Blakely, who was the AAC Player of the Year. Remember back in 2005, they had this kid named Taylor Coppenrath every month. You're a good coach. We also remember the legend of Tom Brennan. What are the chances of you guys repeating 2005 and pulling off a stunning upset in the first round?
You never know. I mean, sometimes that's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. If you get the right matchup, we do have a special player. Marcus Blakely is a phenomenal player. I think he could play at any level of college basketball. And if he plays like he did yesterday, hopefully we can play with someone and give him a game. But, the size, it kind of depends. We don't have a whole lot of size inside. It just really depends on the matchup. But we pulled some upsets. We beat Boston College 3 years ago. They were 14th in the country. We beat Rutgers this year. So we played with some of the big boys. But playing a number two or number three seed, it's going to be a difficult matchup.
All right, we'll see if you guys can get the job done. Best of luck, man. Enjoy the selection process as you find out where you're going for the first round of the big dance.
Thanks a lot, Mike. Appreciate it.